Today I'm going to tell you about the Italian Renaissance and the impact it still has on modern day European life. The Renaissance culture inspired Europe to transition from the ideas of the Middle Ages to a much more modern day outlook, and I'm afraid that the only reference to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles will be this one. In the 13th century, Italy was a patchwork of competing city-states. These northern Italian city-states jostled to become independent of the Holy Roman Empire and the church and its local barons. Trade routes crisscrossed Europe, leading to the Italian states and the Mediterranean ports. The regions of northern and central Italy were among the wealthiest in Europe. But this was also a war-torn era, on land and at sea. And this caused prosperous city-states to maintain expensive armies of mercenaries who often came from Germany and Switzerland. Florence was heavily focused on banking and finance. The gold florin, the currency which enabled international payment and easier international trade. Venice generated huge wealth through the Crusades and the travels of Marco Polo along the Silk Route between 1271 and 1295. Rome was a city of ancient ruins of the Roman Empire. The Papal States were governed by the Pope and remained an area of tension and subject to external interference from France and Spain. The notorious Fourth Crusade between 1202 and 1204 sacked the city of Constantinople and weakened the Byzantine Roman Empire as a rival in the Mediterranean. The Catholic Church explained the will of God, defined the standards of behaviour and the consequences of failure, which at all times could even mean excommunication for a monarch. The church was often left property as people died, and it did not pay taxes to monarchs. And this caused quite some tension, as the popes were also very active politically. For example, Pope Urban II had demanded the First Crusade in 1095. Between 1309 and 1376, the Avignon papacy dispute was over whether the Pope should live in Rome or in Avignon, France. And this actually led to a dispute as to who was Pope. The literary language in Middle Age Italy was Latin, French, or Provençal. A common Italian language did not exist. Italian authors began to change this, writing in their native language, which was a local dialect, and in this case typically a Tuscan dialect. Italian poetry, such as the style of Dolce Stil Novo, Sweet New Style, moved away from the French style of courtly love and was led by poets Giottone d'Arezzo and Guido Guinzelli. Dante Alighieri's Divine Comedy is one of the most important poems of the late Middle Ages and the greatest Italian literary work. The Divine Comedy reflects a medieval society still heavily constrained by the church, and he began to write in Florentine dialect rather than in Latin, which made his work more accessible to the population. The crisis of the late Middle Ages began in the 14th century, and it devastated Europe. A recession, the Great Famine, the Black Death, all decimated the growing population. The failure of the church to protect people from the Black Death in the end weakened its influence over society. The Hundred Years' War between 1337 and 1453, fought between England and France, as well as the campaigns of the Ottoman Empire, disrupted trade routes in the north of Europe and the eastern Mediterranean. In 1345, King Edward III of England defaulted on his debts, causing two large Florentine banks to collapse. The Black Death caused a labour shortage in northern Italy. However, the survivors were wealthier, in work, and better fed. The demand for new products and services would create a new middle class of bankers, merchants, and artisans. This era of instability changed the expectations of the wider public. They expected to be better represented by their government. And there were regular outbreaks of disorder, such as the Chompy Revolt between 1378 and 1382, led by disenfranchised Florentine textile workers. Already, this was an era of evolution in terms of art and music. Giotto di Bondone, known as Giotto, his approach to artistic realism and classicism would inspire Masaccio, Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci in the future. Music was also changing with Trecento, a 14th century secular music, madrigal, vocal music and the ballata. Well, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like this video and subscribe so that others can see it. Join me for part 2. Click here for some more videos you may be interested in.